All right, I realized I have to true the soul of my trying plane also. I put my super straight Mitutoyo ruler on it, and I can see that I'm smiling here on the heel and on the very front too, and I've just got some places just after years of passing this cast iron, which is, you know, relatively soft over very hard woods thousands and thousands of times. I've just got some wear. And so I'm gonna just go ahead and, since I'm getting everything else straight for this video series, I'm gonna go ahead and just straighten this sole too. So what I've done is, I just have this up here so you, as a demonstration, but I want to get this cast iron sole true nice and flat again. And the way I'm gonna do this is, I've got, I went to RSU's. I don't know if you're familiar with them, but they're a really good place to shop for abrasives and things like that. And so I was able to buy a wet dry sandpaper. I bought 3 grits. I bought 60, 80, and 100. And if you've watched any of my sanding videos, you know that when I start sanding, I start with the coarsest that I can get away with to quickly set shape. And that's what I'm gonna do here also. So I've got some 60 grit wet dry paper mounted to my super flat granite block, and I've got it clamped down in place with this. And so I'm just gonna use my Simple Green water cutting fluid, and I'm gonna spritz a little bit underneath here just to make it suck flat down to that granite. And then I'm gonna get this good and saturated. You know, hopefully this is only gonna take a few, these 2 sheets, and I'm not gonna have to use much more than this. I'll just do 60, 80, and 100, and then I've got some 180 that I can kinda clean it up with. But I've got some pretty bad scratches in it. I've got a scratch in here that I know that I hit a hardened steel screw, and so that's gonna be kind of my gauge. And then I've got this grinder mark in here. I've got some issues with it, and so I'm just gonna straighten it out and you know, make it cut a lot better. So let me just go ahead and get after it. Let's take a look and just see what a few passes did to it here. Yeah, but see, I'm getting good coverage all the way to the front here now. Still I'm a little bit weak back here on this heel. But see, when you put some liquid underneath here, it makes that sandpaper suck all the way down. And then again, that's just another reason why using this Simple Green water solution is so nice, is that you just don't feel bashful about using plenty cutting fluid. You know, you're not trying to have to be a miser because the price is so reasonable. Let's see what that looks like. It's not really removing all that much, I can see, because my big scratch mark is still in here. And so let me go ahead and just do a quick look at level, see how fast we're removing this material. That's already a huge improvement. Wow. I'm tipping that blade over, and man, it's just, I mean, it's got to be within just a very small amount to be straight. So I think I'm just going to go ahead and see if I can't, oh, that's still got some cut to it. So I'm just going to go ahead and see if I can wear these 2 sheets out. Thank you. Wow. That looks really good. See, my old terrible grinder marks are still in here. That it's still smiling a little bit back here, but I'm less worried about this than I am about the front. So I think I'm ready to just go to the 80. All right, here's two sheets of 80. Over this big a surface area, it's not taking off very much. It's just leveling it out. Yeah, that's looking really good now. I think I'm just gonna do this 100 and then call it good. I'm not gonna do anything other than that. That's gonna be more than fine for my work. So I bought 10 sheets of each of these grits while I was out. You know, I just wanted to make sure I had something on hand. And so that should last me a while. I normally don't use wet dry paper unless I'm doing something like this. Probably dress these edges since they look so ratty, but that means that I'm gonna have to lose my 15 amp sticker that I've had on here for so long, but I guess I'm gonna have to do it. That's good enough. Yeah, that because I've never really done anything to these sides too much. So, you know, they actually dress this up in a pretty coarse manner, really. Oh, that looks so good. It's like getting a brand new hand plane. I like to use mineral oil if I'm going to use any kind of petroleum product to put on my planes and stuff, just to inhibit rust, because it doesn't stink. And So, you know, this shows you can take an old plane, may not be the world's greatest plane, and without a huge financial investment, you can kind of dress it up and clean it up and true it and get it running right again. But, you know, that's not bad. You can see my Duff beer poster reflection in that, and that's just to 100. You know, I don't see any point in going beyond that because it's just going to get scratched up again anyway.